eyes on our Savior. CDM of love, sing His praises forever. Creation, waking up to kingdom come. See the hope of heaven shining like the rising sun. And forever lifted up from death to life. There's no fear in love, and in darkness in its endless light. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us. The everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior. Of love, sing His praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love, sing His praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Beyond the skies, beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love, sing His praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love, sing His praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Sun, set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love, sing His praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Sing salvation. Salvation, tearing through the dead of night. See the kingdom burst into color at the speed of light. Freedom, shaking up the atmosphere. As the shadows fade into nothing as the day appears. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love, sing His praises forever. waking up to kingdom come. See the hope of heaven shining like the rising sun. Skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. On the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love. Sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. Sing salvation. Salvation tearing through the dead of night. See the kingdom burst into color at the speed of light. Freedom shaking up the atmosphere as the shadows fade into nothing as the day appears. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us. Everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun. Set our eyes on our Savior. See the image of love. Sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Creation waking up to kingdom come. See the hope of heaven shining like the rising sun. And forever beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Oh, we look to the sun, set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun. On the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Beyond the skies above, love reaching out for us, the everlasting one, Jesus our God. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Set our eyes on our Savior, see the image of love, sing his praises forever. Oh, we look to the sun. Oh, we look to the sun.
Brothers and sisters, are you ready to worship the Lord? Let's invite the Lord into our midst by calling each other to worship. Now together, we gather in your name, Lord Jesus. Nothing can separate us from your love. Nothing can hinder you from working in our lives. You are the way, the truth, and the life. Speak with authority in our lives, Lord Jesus. We do not live by bread alone, but by every word that you speak. Fulfill in us all your purposes, and let the earth be filled with your glory. We give you all our worship. We give you all our praises. You alone, we long to worship. You alone are worthy of all our praises.
Best for my own life. Holy Word. You never Almighty, we humbly bow before you and declare that you are the Lord of all creation and the Lord of our lives. We pray that you strengthen the church by your Spirit. May the Church of Jesus Christ in Malaysia grow in maturity, rooted and established in love. Help us to comprehend your greatness and your promises in your word. Bless us with the knowledge that surpasses all understanding, that we may experience the fullness of who you are. May you show us miracles in our work, that signs and wonders will follow those who share your good news to the lost, and all glory to your name. Sovereign God, your word says that our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms. May you release a spirit of prayer upon the church. Empower us to persevere, to pray with all kinds of prayers and requests for the church and the nation. Lord, out of your mercy, grant our nation repentance, leading us to a knowledge of the truth, and many will come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil, who has taken many captive to do his will. God of righteousness, turn our nation's heart towards righteousness, justice, and the fear of the Lord. May you bless our nation with upright, just, diligent leaders of integrity in government, so that our nation will be peaceful and stable. Lord, we pray for all those who are going through difficult times in life. Help them to see their situations from your perspective and to trust in your ability and not their own. We pray for those who are tired and weary to experience your comforting presence. May you be the strength for those who are weak, light for those who are walking in darkness, and hope for those who are depressed. We pray that you will provide solutions to their problems and answers to their prayers. May your peace reign in their hearts as they put their hope and trust in you. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
Now, let's recite our purpose statement together. We choose to be, in a process, where we follow Jesus Christ and obey His commands, hence influencing others to do the same. Next is our announcement for this week. The first announcement would be Alpha Course. Alpha will begin this June and will be conducted via Zoom. Do you have any friends, families, and relatives who wants to know more about Christianity? Grab this opportunity and invite them to join us. To know more, you may contact Preacher Jennifer or refer to the e-bulletin. The next announcement will be KKE Helpline. If you need any prayer, or if you have any inquiries, or even if you need any assistance, we are here for you. Do reach out and WhatsApp KKE Helpline, and we will assist you as best as we can. CG Zoom Meeting. CG continues to meet virtually. If you'd like to be part of a CG, please get in touch with one and join the weekly CG Zoom Gathering. Alternatively, WhatsApp KKE Helpline and we will assist you. Next off, it's our tithes and offering. For KKE members, you now have three options to give: online transfer, Boost apps, and drive-thru. For members who prefer to physically offer your tithes and offerings, KKE has come up with a way for you to do so. You just need to follow the signages as you drive into the church compound and drop off your tithes and offerings. The set times are Wednesday, Thursdays, and Fridays from 10 a.m. to 12 noon. Feel free to make your way there. For guests who are with us, you may also give your tithes and offerings if you wish to, with no obligations. While members from other EGC churches, you may pass your givings to your respective churches. That's all from me for the announcement for this week.
Good morning, church. Let us pray.
大家早上好，让我们一起来祷告。
Dear Lord, draw us into your presence this morning and create in us a posture of waiting upon you to hear from you. Cause our ears to be sensitive to your voice calling us. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
亲爱的主上帝，今天早上让我们进入你的同在，并在我们当中建立等候聆听你声音的体态，使我们的耳朵勉励你呼唤我们的声音，奉基督的名祷告， Amen.
Today, let us look at a passage from 1 Samuel chapter 3, the account of God calling the boy Samuel for the first time.
今天让我们一起来看撒母耳记上三章，这是上帝第一次呼唤撒母耳这男孩。
Which also marked the beginning of Samuel's ministry as a prophet, a priest, the last ruling judge in the Old Testament, and the first kingmaker.
这也标志着撒母耳侍奉的开始，成为先知、祭司，也是旧约中最后的一位士师。他也是高扫罗成为以色列的第一位国王。
He anointed Saul as the first king of Israel and later anointed David as the next king in line when Saul failed in his kingship.
后来他又高大卫为第二任的国王，代替了失败后的扫罗王。
Samuel's name carries the meaning of name of God, son of God, or God heard.
撒母耳的名字带有神的名字，神的儿子，或神听见的含义。
For Samuel's mother Hannah prayed to God at Shiloh and asked for a son. Her prayer was heard and answered. God heard.
因为撒母耳的母亲 Hannah 在示罗向神祷告，并要求一个儿子，她的祷告被听到了，并得到了答案。神听到了。
After Samuel was weaned from his mother, Hannah took him to the temple at Shiloh.Dedicated him and left him there under the care of Eli.
撒母耳从母亲那里断奶后，哈拿将他带到示罗的圣殿，奉献给耶和华，并留他在以利的照顾下。
Therefore, Samuel grew up in the temple, ministering and serving under the priest Eli.
因此，撒母耳在圣殿里长大，学习侍奉。在祭司以利的引导下
Now let us turn to the word of the Lord in 1 Samuel chapter 3, verse 1 to 14. Here reads the word of the Lord. Now the boy Samuel was ministering to the Lord under Eli. The word of the Lord was rare in those days. Visions were not widespread. At that time, Eli, whose eyesight had begun to grow dim so that he could not see, was lying down in his room. The Lamb of God had not yet gone out, and Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord, where the Ark of God was. Then the Lord called, "Samuel, Samuel." And he said, "Here I am," and ran to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call. Lie down again." So he went and lay down. The Lord called again, "Samuel." Samuel got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." But he said, "I did not call, my son. Lie down again." Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him. The Lord called Samuel again a third time. And he got up and went to Eli and said, "Here I am, for you called me." Then Eli perceived that the Lord was calling the boy. Therefore Eli said to Samuel, "Go lie down, and if he calls you, you shall say, 'Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.'" So Samuel went and lay down in his place. Now the Lord came and stood there, calling as before, "Samuel, Samuel." And Samuel said, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Then the Lord said to Samuel, "See, I am about to do something in Israel that will make both ears of anyone who hears of it tingle. On that day, I will fulfill against Eli all that I have spoken concerning his house, from beginning to end. For I have told him that I am about to punish his house forever for the iniquity that he knew, because his sons were blaspheming God, and he did not restrain them. Therefore I swear to the house of Eli that the iniquity of Eli's house shall not be expiated by sacrifice or offering forever." The first point, the Lord calls you by name.
耶和华呼唤你的名.
From verses 1 to 14, we see that four times the Lord called out to Samuel by his name, Samuel, Samuel.
从第一节至14节, 我们看到耶和华四次呼唤撒母耳的名字, 撒母耳, 撒母耳.
And verse 7 tells us that Samuel did not recognize the voice of God because he is yet to know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him.
第七节告诉我们, 撒母耳还不认识耶和华, 也未得知耶和华的默示.
But each time he heard his name being called out, he was alert in his sleep.
但是每当他听到自己的名字被呼唤时, 他都会在睡眠中保持警惕.
He answered immediately and ran to Eli, thinking it was Eli who called.
他立即回答并跑到以利那里, 以为是以利在呼唤他.
Because the way God calls out to Samuel sounded so intimate.
因为耶和华呼唤撒母耳的方式听起来如此的亲密.
Like someone who knows Samuel very well, it did not sound authoritative or formal at all.
就像他非常了解撒母耳一样,听起来完全没有权威性或形式化的.
God did not say, "Samuel, son of Elkanah, this is my word for you."
耶和华没有说, 以利加拿的儿子撒母耳, 这是我对你说的话.
But he called him, "Samuel, Samuel."
但耶和华呼唤他, 撒母耳, 撒母耳.
And God waited for his reply.
上帝等候他的答复.
So what does this tell us about our God?
这告诉我们有关我们的主上帝是如何的呢?
Isaiah 43 verse 1 tells us, "But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, He who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. In this verse, God is speaking to the nation, to the community, O Jacob, O Israel.
在这节经文中，耶和华对国家、对社区说话。
O Jacob, O Israel, He is assuring them that they are special to Him.
雅各啊，以色列啊，耶和华，他们保证他们对他来说是特殊的。
For He formed them and called them by name. They are His.
因为他造了他们，并说，我曾提你的名召你，你是属我的。
The verb he who formed you painted for us the image of a potter working and forming the clay.
这造成你的那位为我们绘画了陶匠的形象。
Just like Genesis 2:7, the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostril and breath the breath of life.
就像在创世纪第二章七节中一样。耶和华神从地上的尘土造人，向他的鼻孔呼出生命的气息，这个人就成了生物。
God has a personal touch in His creation. He formed and shaped them.
耶和华在他的创造中具有个人的风格，他形成并塑造了他们。
He formed and shaped you and me to be who we are today.
他也塑造也形成你和我今天的我们。
And indeed, we are special to Him because he knows us and He calls us by name and said that we are His.
确实，我们对他很特别，他以我们的名字认识我们，以名字呼唤我们，并说我们是属于他的。
And several other verses in the Bible also show us that God always make the initial move.To look for people, to come to them, and calls them out by name, so that he can reveal himself to them.
圣经中其他的经节也向我们表明，耶和华总是采取最初的行动来寻找人，来到人那里，并按他们的名字呼唤，并向他们显示他自己。
For example, Genesis chapter 3 verse 9,After Adam and Eve sinned and hid from the Lord in the Garden of Eden, the Lord God called to the man and said to him, Where are you?
亚当和夏娃犯罪之后，在伊甸园的花园里躲藏起来。主神呼唤那人，对他说，你在哪里？
Exodus chapter 3 verse 4 to 6, the Lord appeared to Moses in the burning bush.
出埃及记三章四至六节。耶和华在燃烧的荆棘中向摩西显现。
He called to him out of the bush, Moses, Moses.
耶和华从荆棘中呼唤他，摩西，摩西。
And he said, Here I am.
他说，我在这里。
And then in verse 6, God revealed himself to Moses, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob.
然后在第六节中，耶和华向摩西表明自己，我是你父亲的神，亚伯拉罕的神，以撒的神和雅各的神。
And in the New Testament, Acts chapter 9, verse 3 to 5.
在新约，使徒行传九章三至五节。
Saul was going along and approaching Damascus. Suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him.
扫罗行路将到大马士革，忽然从天上发光，四面照着他。
He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me?
他就伏倒在地，听见有声音对他说，扫罗，扫罗，你为什么逼迫我？
He asked, Who are you, Lord? The reply came, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting.
他说，主啊，你是谁？主说，我就是你所逼迫的耶稣。
Samuel, Samuel.
撒母耳，撒母耳。
Moses, Moses, Saul, Saul.
摩西，摩西，扫罗，扫罗。
Or in my case, Yiping, Yiping, Jennifer, Jennifer.
或者在我的历列中是依萍，依萍。Jennifer, Jennifer.
Our Lord knows us by name.
我们的主以名字认识我们。
He is personal with us.
他与我们同在。
He formed and created us and called us His own.
他形成并创造了我们，并称我们是属他的。
He came to us and met with us so that we can encounter Him and know Him.
他来与我们相会，以便我们可以与他相遇并认识他。
Secondly, we see that Samuel is in a posture of readiness to listen.
其次，我们看到撒母耳随时准备静听的体态。
Every time he heard his name being called out, he answered immediately.
他每次听到自己的名字被呼唤的时候，他都会立刻回答。
He did not just answer, "Yes, I'm here. What do you want?"
他不仅回答是我在这里，你想要什么？
But he got up three times immediately when his name is called and went to Eli to answer him.
而是当他的名字被呼唤之后，他立即起身三遍，并且回答伊利。
This showed us Samuel's alertness and readiness to listen and respond.
这向我们显示了撒母耳的警惕和乐意倾听和回应的能力。
Why was he so alert?
为什么他那么的警惕呢？
Where was Samuel when the Lord called him?
耶和华呼唤他的时候，撒母耳在哪里呢？
Verse 3 says, Samuel was lying down in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was.
第三节说，撒母耳是躺在耶和华约柜所在的耶和华的殿中。
The ark of God represents God's presence.
神的约柜代表了耶和华的同在。
And the contents kept inside the ark were the tables of the Mosaic law, a pot of manna, and the rod of Aaron.
放在约柜里的是摩西律法的设板，一罐玛拿和亚伦的杖。
So Samuel was resting in the presence of God.
因此撒母耳在耶和华的面前休息，
staying close to the Mosaic law, the manna and the Aaron's rod.
紧贴着摩西律法、玛拿和亚伦的杖。
But verse 1 tells us that during those days the word of the Lord was rare and the visions were not widespread.
但是第一节告诉我们，在那段的日子，耶和华的话语稀少，异象还没有传播。
So up until that point of time, Samuel has never heard the voice of God.
所以直到那个时候，撒母耳都没有听到耶和华的声音。
Even though he was serving all his life in the temple.
即使他在圣殿中服侍。
So with this, we also should not assume that anyone who grew up in a Christian home will know the Lord automatically.
因此我们也不应该假设在基督徒家庭长大的任何人都会自动的认识主。
Samuel lying down in the temple of the Lord where the ark of God was.
撒母耳躺在神的约柜所在的耶和华殿中。
This verse has led some scholars or historians to believe that what Samuel practiced was known to the ancient Near Eastern people as incubation.
这节经文使一些的学者或历史学家相信撒母耳的侍宿被古代近东方人称为复活。
Which involves going to a sacred place, offer sacrifices to God, and then fall asleep, hoping that God will visit them in a dream to give them a divine vision or a dream.
其中射到神圣的地方，向神献祭，然后入睡，希望神在梦中拜访他们，使他们拥有神圣的视野或梦想。
The word incubation led me to think of the incubator for the eggs.
软化这个词使我想到了软培养箱。
Where the eggs are laid inside a box with lights shining on it to give warmth. And when the right time comes, the eggs will be hatched into little chicken.
将卵放在一个盒子里，上面放着灯，照得温暖。适当的时候，这些卵会被孵化成小鸡。
In the church office, some of us, when tasked to preach or share, will go into one of the small rooms in our office.
在我们教会的办公室里，我们当中如被安排到讲道或分享信息时，都会进入到我们办公室的一个小房间，我们称它为洞穴
，which we call our caves.
我们称它为洞穴。
I, for one, will always look for our caves.
我都会一直寻找我的洞穴
，to separate myself from the others and hoping to hear from the Lord more clearly.
以分割自己，希望在准备讲道时能更清楚听到主的声音。
To receive a word, a revelation when preparing for the sermon.
得到一个启示。
This has become my incubation room.
那就成为我的卵培养室。
In the church, the pastoral staff especially,
在教会里，尤其是教牧同工，
were also encouraged to go for our personal retreat once a year.
每年都会鼓励去做我们的个人进修。
To seek God and hear from Him.
寻求神并听从他。
During those few days, we are not to do work, but to rest in the Lord's presence.
在那几天里，我们不工作，而要在主的面前安息。
Read the Bible, pray, and to hear from Him.
读圣经，祈祷并聆听他。
Well, this practice is not confined only to full-time worker.
这种做法不仅限于全职牧者。
Any Christians who wishes to set aside time to hear from the Lord, to receive revelation from the Lord, can try doing this.
任何希望预留时间聆听主的启示、接受主启示的基督徒都可以尝试这么的做。
So Samuel was ready and waiting to hear from the Lord.
因此，撒母耳准备好等待着聆听耶和华。
So that's why he was so alert and responsive to the call.
这就是为什么他如此的警惕并响应耶和华的呼唤。
He was in a posture of readiness to listen and respond.
他准备好聆听和回应。
To hear from the Lord, we must be in a posture of readiness and eagerness to listen.
要听取耶和华的声音，我们必须处于准备和渴望聆听的体态。
Sometimes we hear Christian asking, "How do I hear from the Lord?"
有时候我们会听到基督徒会问，我怎么能听到主呢？
Why is it that God seems to speak to other people but not me?
为什么神是否是在和别人说话而不是我呢？
God, why are you silent and not saying anything to me?
神，为什么你保持静默而不对我说话呢？
God, can you please open your mouth and tell me something?
神啊，请你开口，告诉我一些事情。
Notice that when we say all these, the me, M-E, is very big.
请注意，当我们说这些话时，这个我字非常的大。
Demanding God to speak.
要要求神听我们的话。
The focus is so much on ourselves rather than in a posture of humility.Seeking to hear from the Lord.
我们把自己放在重点，而不是谦卑地寻求主的声音。
When we are in the right posture of humbleness,
当我们处于谦虚和正确的体态时，
Jeremiah 29 verses 12 to 14 tells us, Then when you call upon me and come and pray to me, I will hear you.When you search for me, you will find me. If you seek me with all your heart, I will let you find me, says the Lord. Finally,
最后
the Lord reveals himself by the word.
耶和华以道显示自己。
First Samuel chapter 3 verse 7.
撒母耳记上三章七节。
Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, and the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him.
撒母耳不认识主，主的话还没有向他启示。
According to the Jewish historian Josephus,
根据犹太历史家约瑟夫斯的说法，
Samuel has just completed his 12 years when the word of the Lord came to him.
撒母耳刚刚满了12岁，当耶和华的圣言降临于他。
Though he grew up in the temple, he did not yet know the Lord, because the word of the Lord had not yet been revealed to him.
尽管他在圣殿中长大，但他仍不认识主，因为主的话尚未向他启示。
Luke chapter 2 verse 42 tells us,
路加福音二章四十二节。
Similarly, Jesus' first visit to the temple was also at the age of 12.
同样，耶稣第一次去圣殿的时候也只有十二岁。
When he stayed on in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them many questions.
他留在圣殿，坐在教室的中间，听他们讲，并且问了许多的问题。
To the Jewish boys,
对于十二岁的一个犹太男孩来说，
12 years old was a critical point in their lives.
这是他们生命中的关键时刻。
When they become men, once they achieve puberty, typically around age 13.
一旦他们进入青春期，通常是在13岁左右，他们就成为男人。
They would then qualify for bar mitzvah.
他们将有资格参加成人礼，
which is the initiation ceremony of Jewish boys who have reached 13 years of age.
这是达到13岁的犹太男孩的入学典礼。
And are regarded as ready to observe religious precepts and eligible to take part in public worship.
这个年岁便视为愿意遵守宗教戒律并有资格参加公共礼拜。
They now become son of the law.
他们现在成为律法之子。
And will now be personally responsible for the obedience of the law.
并将对律遵守律法负有个人的责任。
This age is quite similar to our church practice for teenagers who wishes to go through the confirmation.
这个年龄与我们教会青少年愿意参加坚信礼课程的系列非常的相似。
We usually advise them not to rush.
我们通常都建议他们不用着急，
but wait until they turn 13, where they are more ready.
要等到他们13岁时，
to more ready to personally and be responsible for the obedience of the word.
他们才更愿意亲自对圣经的服从负责，并做出个人决定跟随耶稣。
And to make personal decisions to follow Jesus.
并做出个人决定跟随耶稣。
The end of chapter 3, verses 19 to 21. As Samuel grew up, the Lord was with him, and let none of his words fall to the ground. And all Israel from Dan to Beersheba knew that Samuel was a trustworthy prophet of the Lord. The Lord continued to appear at Shiloh, for the Lord revealed himself to Samuel at Shiloh by the word of the Lord. To know God is to know the word of God.
认识耶和华是透过神的话语。
Hebrews chapter 1 verse 1 to 3 also tells us, Long ago, God spoke to our ancestors in many and various ways by the prophets.But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a son, whom he appointed heir of all things, through whom he also created the world. He is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being, and he sustains all things by his powerful word. To know God is also to know the Son of God.
认识耶和华是透过认识神的儿子。
Verse 2 says, God has spoken to us by a son, and that's Jesus Christ.
神已经有一个儿子对我们说话，那就是耶稣基督。
Who is the reflection of God's glory and the exact imprint of God's very being.
是神荣耀的反影，也是神存在确迹的印记。
John chapter 1 verse 1 also say, In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
约翰福音一章一节说道，大初有道，道与神同在，道就是神。
Therefore we see that God, the Lord, will reveal himself to us by the spoken word, which is the Bible.
因此我们可以看到上帝透过他的话语就是圣经。
And the word himself, who is Jesus.
和道就是耶稣。
To know God and to know what He says to us, let us go to the Bible and let us go to Jesus.
要认识神并知道神对我们说的话，我们要去到圣经并认识耶稣。
In conclusion, I want to draw your attention to the fourth time God calls Samuel.
总结，我想提起你的注意，耶和华第四次召集撒母耳。
When Eli realized that it was the Lord calling the boy,
当以利意识到这是耶和华呼唤这个男孩时，
he taught Samuel to reply and say, Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.
他教导撒母耳这样回答说，主啊，请说，你的仆人静听。
Why didn't Eli hear the message on behalf of Samuel?
以利为什么不代表撒母耳听这信息呢？
Well, he was the priest and the prophet. Surely the Lord can speak through him.
既然他是祭司又是先知，当然可以和主说话。
But Eli knew that this message is for Samuel to hear and not him.
但是以利知道这个信息是撒母耳听到的，而不是他。
So he taught Samuel to hear from the Lord himself.
因此他教导撒母耳听从耶和华自己的信息。
Well, in life, many of us would want to take the shortcut or make things easier.
在生活中，我们许多人都喜欢走捷径或使事情变得容易。
So we go to some people who are more spiritual, tell them our problem, and ask them some questions concerning the Christian faith, and then say, You pray for me and see what the Lord is saying about my situation.
所以我们去找一些灵命更好的人，告诉他们我们的问题，或向他们问有关基督信仰的问题，然后说，你为我祈祷，并看上帝怎么样对我的境状说话呢？
Or you let me know what is the answer.
或许你让我知道答案是什么。
We are impatient to wait upon the Lord ourselves.
我们很不耐烦地等着上帝。
We hope to hear from God or hear about God through someone else's mouth.
我们很希望从别人那里听到有关上帝的消息。
Well, I'm not denying that there are times that God does speak to us through other people.
是的，我并不是否认有时候神会通过其他的人对我们说话。
But what I'm encouraging you today is to learn from Samuel.
但是我今天要鼓励你的是要向撒母耳学习。
Stay in God's presence.
留在神的同在。
Draw near to God through His spoken words, the Bible, and go to Jesus, the Word.
透过他的话语，就是圣经，来亲近神，借着耶稣，就是他的道。
And hear from Him directly.
直接从他那里听见他要告诉你的信息。
Today you may have many questions that need an answer.
今天你可能有很多的问题需要答案。
Why don't you go to God directly? And say to him, Speak, Lord, for your servant is listening.
你为什么不直接去找上帝，并对上帝说，请说，主啊，你的仆人静听。
Remember, go to him in a posture of readiness to hear and a posture of humility.
记住，要准备好静听并谦卑的体态。
May God bless you.
愿神赐福你。
receive now the blessings. May the God of peace, our constant companion, lead us along paths of solidarity and hope. The God of love forever hold us tight in life's endeavors and give us the joy of being united in God's love. May the peace of God, our Heavenly Father, and the grace of Christ, the risen Son, and the fellowship of God the Spirit, keep our hearts and minds within His love. Amen.
Thank you everyone for joining us for our online service. Last but not least, remember to follow us on our Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube channel at BCCMKK English for the latest updates and online services. See you next week, and Shalom.
Filled with doubt, we dismiss what we can't figure out. Oh, but I don't have to see to believe in it. I know that it's true 'cause I'm feeling it. I don't need the one to agree with it. No, there's just too much proof in my life.
Sing your head.